We'll be heading for Guam, which was the site of where Trias went out in 1960 to the Challenger Deep in the Mariana Trench. So we're going to the Mariana Trench. We're going to a different place, though, a little closer to Guam, called the Siena Deep. And that depth there is about 150 meters shallower than Challenger Deep. So it's the second deepest place on the planet, on a par with the Tonga Trench. The expedition is to gather water from the benthic boundary layer, the bottom 10 meters nearest the seafloor. So the way it works is these spheres give us buoyancy, and they lift up at about 100 pounds of buoyancy. And we carry a package down below, which is neutral. It's really hollow plastic PVC tubes with caps that are open on either end, at the top and at the bottom as well. And the third part of the machine is actually the anchors here, which are just iron. So there's about 150 pounds of iron right here, and that 150 pounds pulls down with more force than the 100 pounds of buoyancy pulls up. So this thing is fighting all the way down. The buoyancy is lifting up and the anchor's pulling down. Anchor wins and takes it all the way to the seafloor. We're after water at the deep ocean depth. And how it works is it's just a big pipe. It's open on the top and open on the bottom. And right through the middle, we got a big spring. And the spring comes up to these doors, these lids right here. And there's a lid on the other side. Let me flip it around. So here's the top lid on both of them. And then the bottom lid down below. And they're held open right here by a mechanical link. And right now we just have rope here, but there'll be a mechanical link here. And when we trigger it to release from the timer or from the acoustics, a little mechanism here opens up and it drops the anchor, and then these things are free to close. So these bottles then snap shut, and that entire cylinder is full of water that was captured at the seafloor. The fundamental reason we're going out on this particular trip with this machine is we were funded by NASA in an exobiology grant to study the life in the very extreme environments of the deep sea. NASA believes there may be an analog between what we find in the deepest ocean trench and what may potentially be found on the moon of Jupiter called Europa. Their ocean there is actually deeper than our ocean on Europa, but its planetary size is smaller, so although it's deeper, the pressure would be the same. So we're looking for clues of life that may exist on Europa. So Doug Bartlett is the principal investigator and the marine genomist who is helping NASA understand planetary bioscience. This machine really is the first of a new class. It's really opening up new windows into the future for us. But in large measure, Scripps has actually got a great legacy of deep ocean exploration with Claude Zobel, Art Ioannis, for example. And John Isaacs, who did some great work in the 1960s and 70s with free vehicles. So we really stand on their shoulders. And if we see further, it's because we have great people that precede us and allow us to do this work today.